والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد, أحبتي في الله, I wanted to share one very important message, and that's the message of being sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the most important reason why I want to share this with you is to remind myself, and then is to remind you, my brothers and sisters, because the shaitan is haris. The shaitan is vigilant in distracting us from the truth, calling us to shirk in its various manifestations, calling us to kufr and bid'ah and ilhad in all of its various manifestations. The shaitan wants you to worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And do not think that your sins are not a means to doing that. As Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said, al-ma'asi barid al-kufr, that sinfulness is a means to disbelief. So think about those callers to bid'ah, those callers ala abwaba jahannam, like some of the individuals we've been talking about recently, these Einstein people who have reached such a level in their understanding that they no longer need to be withheld and restricted by the minhaj of the Salaf al-Saleh. They have a new way, a new methodology. Where do you think all new manahij is going to lead you? Ala aqal, astray. In the most minor way of deviation, it's going to lead you somewhere astray. But it can lead you to the hellfire too easy. May Allah bless us with ikhlass, with abad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the nations before us, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ اللَّهُ دِينَهُ نَفَاءَ وَيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ. And they were not commanded except to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Mukhlisin. How were they asked to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? With sincerity. Mukhlis. Sincerely to Him. Meaning no shirk of idols. No shirk of rats. No shirk of dogs. No shirk of worshiping elephants. No any type of worship to anything with Allah besides Allah. No one, nothing shares in divinity with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Not the Anbiya, alayhim afdal salatu wasalam, not the Malaika, alayhim salatu wasalam. So, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ. How were they ordered to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? With sincerity, purely worshiping Him and Him alone. On the deen of Ibrahim, alayhi salatu wasalam, which is the deen of sincerity, and the deen of rejecting shirk in all of its forms and all of the manahij and all the ideologies of shirk and polytheism and the people of polytheism. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ حُنَفَاءَ وَيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ, and establish the prayer and establish the zakat. وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيْمَةِ, and that is the straight religion. So that is the deen of Tawheed. That's what we're ordered to. That's what we're ordered to call to. Is the deen al-qayyimah. We're supposed to practice. And guess what? Those are from the arkan al-Islam. The first being what? The testimony of faith. Buni al-Islam al-Khams. Islam is built on five pillars. The first one is shahada in la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah, bearing witness that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad is his last prophet and messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, and establishing the prayer and paying the zakat, wa sawm Ramadan, fasting Ramadan, wa hajj al-bayt, and istata'ta ilayhi sabil, if you're able to make the hajj. Those are the pillars of Islam. So the people before us were ordered with the prayer and the zakat. That's what they were commanded to. And all of that is a part of worshipping Allah. As Allah mentioned, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ, they were not commanded except to worship Allah. So that means they were commanded to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions a specific type of worship after He mentioned the general worship, because all worship goes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the specific worship is the salat, وَيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُوا الزَّكَاةَ, to establish the prayer and pay the zakat. Those are types of ibadah that must be done for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are all falling under ibadah. I want to mention one hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is a scary hadith. And I love this hadith. And I can recall a warrior that I once mentioned this hadith in his in his company. A warrior, meaning he is a beloved brother to me that has been striving on the sunnah for many years. And to see him, because he's strong in his body and strong in his honor. And I to see this warrior cry, he cried. His heart was moved. He doesn't know Arabic, but he was moved by the text of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Listen to this beautiful hadith. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن الأول الناس يقضى يوم القيامة عليه رجل استشهد فأتي به فعرفه نعمه فعرفها قال فما عملت فيها قال قتلت فيك حتى استشهدت قال كذبت ولكنك فعلت لأن يقال هو جريء فقد قيل ثم أمر به فصحب على وجهه حتى ألقي في النار. So Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, verily, the first people on the day of judgment who will be brought before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and judged, the first will be a man who was martyred. And we know the status of the martyr. The martyr, that's one of the highest deeds you can do in Islam. Listen, all these people did the best deeds you can do in Islam. So take note of what are the best deeds that we can do and what can happen if we don't have ikhlas, if we're not sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he was brought before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He'll be brought before Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And he'll be asked, what did you do? He said, I was martyred. And I was martyred for your sake. And it will be made known what he did, you know. And he will say, قَتَلْتُ فِيكَ حَتُّ اسْتُشِتَ I fought for your sake until I was martyred. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, can you imagine your Lord, Rabbil Alameen, saying to you, كَذَّبْتُ You lied. But rather you did it so that the people would say you were brave. فَقَدْ قِيلَ And it was said about you. So what does that mean, حَبَتَ فِي اللَّهِ It means that this person who was showing off, they got their reward in the dunya because the people praised him for being brave. But what a brave warrior. What a brave mujahid. Look at the videos that he was martyred in. MashaAllah, he was shot like this. And they buried him. They dug him in the grave and put him in the grave like this. And subhanAllah, he had a smile on his face like this. We have many pictures of it. We have many videos of it. فَقَدْ قِيلَ It was said about him. فَأُتِيَ بِهِ فَعَرَفُونِ And then he'll be dragged in his face and thrown in the hellfire. Can you imagine martyrdom and being thrown in the fire? Doing the highest deed you could in Islam, one of the highest deeds you could do. Being martyred. Man qatala li takun kalimatullahi ulya fuhuwa fi sabilillah azza wa jalla. But instead, it brought you to the hellfire. And the second one, wa rajulun ta'allama al-'ilm. This is very scary for us. وَعَلَّمَهُ وَقَرَى الْقُرْآنَ فَأُتِيَ بِهِ فَعَرْفُهُ نِعَمُهُ فَعَرْفَهَا قَالَ فَمَا عَمَلْتَ فِيهَا قَالَ تَعَلَّمْتُ الْعِلْمَ وَعَلَّمْتُهُ وَقَرَأْتُ فِيكَ الْقُرْآنَ قَالَ كَذَّبْتَ وَلَكِنَّكَ تَعَلَّمْتَ لِيُقَالَ عَالِمٌ وَقَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ لِيُقَالَ هُوَ قَارِئٌ فَقَدْ قِيلَ ثُمَّ أُمِرَ بِهِ فَصُحِبَ عَلَى وَجْهِهِ حَتَّى أُلْقِيَ فِي النَّارِ So the second one is the man he's تَعَلَّمْتَ الْعِلْمَ He learned knowledge. We love طَالَبَ الْعِلْمَ All of us, we're trying. Some of us are, we're trying. We're just doing the best we can. Or maybe we're not doing the best we can, but at least we're trying something. Okay? تَعَلَّمْتَ الْعِلْمُ وَعَلَّمْتُهُ And I taught the people with it. I learned some knowledge and I taught the people with it. وَقَرَى فِيكَ الْقُرْآنِ And I recited the Quran for you. So this person could be a hafiz, a beautiful reciter. And then his ni'mah will be made known. And Allah will say to him, you lied. But rather you did it so that the people would say, Alimun, that you are an alim, you are a scholar, or you are one of the major scholars, or you are a talib al-ilm. You got that. Or you are a qari, a beautiful reciter. You got that. Faqad qil. This is so powerful. That means it was said about you in this life, You got your reward. Your reward was in the dunya, that the people praised you. The people gave you likes on your videos. The people gave you this. The people loved you. They gave you money. They gave you women. They gave you cars and a dawah helicopter or whatever. They gave you that in this dunya. But you didn't get in the hereafter. You got the hellfire. And the last one. وَرَجُلٌ وَسَعَ الْعَنَيْهِ وَعَطَاهُ مِنْ أَسْنَافِ الْمَالِ فَأُتِيَ بِهِ فَعَرَفُهُ نِعَمُهُ فَعَرَفَهَا قَالَ فَمَا عَمَلْتَ فِيهَا قَالَ مَا تَرَكْتُ مِنْ سَبِيلِي تُحِبُّ أَنْ يَنْفَقَ فِيهَا إِلَّا أَنْفَقْتُ فِيهَا لَكْ قَالَ كَذَّبْتُ وَلَكِنَّكَ فَعَلْتَ لِيُقَالَ هُوَ جَوَادٌ فَقَدْ قِيلْ ثُمَّ أُمِرَ بِهِ فَصُحِبَ لَوَجْهِهِ حَتَّى أُلْكِيَ فِي النَّارِ. So the last one was a man, he was given all kind of wealth. وَسَعَ عَلَيْهِ. Allah gave him, favored him with wealth. How many of us, we desire wealth? I would like some wealth. I could do a lot of good. I hope I would do good. And I'm making dua for it. I don't know how Allah is going to give it to me. I don't know if Allah is going to give it to me. And I don't know how I would end with that wealth. So Allah gave him lots of wealth. وَعْتَاهُ مِنْ أَسْنَافِ الْمَالِ. So this man was blessed with a lot of wealth. And he وَعْتَاهُ مِنَ الْمَالِ. He gave him min al-mal. فَأُتِيَ بِهِ فَعَرَفُهُ نِعَمُهُ. So his blessing was made known. قَالَ. So Allah will ask him, فَمَا عَمَلْتَ فِيهَا. What did you do with that wealth that I gave you? Those blessings, that ni'mam, that ni'am Allah gave you. What did you do? قَالَ. مَا تَرَكْتَ مِنْ سَبِيلَ أَن تُحِبُّ أَن يَنْفَقَ فِيهَا إِلَّا أَنْفَقْتَ فِيهَا لَكْ. إِلَّا أَنْفَقْتُ فِيهَا لَكْ. مَا تَرَكْتُ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ. That's powerful. I didn't leave off a path. There was no path that I didn't leave spending in your cause. There wasn't a way. مَا تَرَكْتُ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ أَنْ تُحِبُّ أَنْ يَنْفَقَ فِيهَا إِلَّا أَنْفَقْتُ فِيهَا لَكْ. I didn't leave off any way of spending money except that I spent it in your path. That's powerful. مَا تَرَكْتُ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ. That means maybe masajid, charities, spending on the poor, making trusts, building masajid, everything, building marakis of sunnah, places where the people could study the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all kind of good, spending on his parents, spending on this. مَا تَرَكْتَ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ تُحِبُّ أَنْ يَنْفَقَ فِيهَا لَنْفَقْتَ فِيهَا لَكْ. Because these are the paths that Allah loves, as he said. I didn't leave off a path. And guess what Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is going to say? Kadhabt. You lied. Or rather, you did it so that the people would say you were a spendthrift or a philanthropist. فَقَدْ قِيلْ. And it was said. ثُمَّ سُحِبَ لَوَجْهِهِ ثُمَّ أُلْكِيَ فِي النَّارِ. So in the last, this last individual is dragged in his face, then thrown in the fire. أَحَبَتِ فِي اللَّهِ. I say this as a reminder to myself and others, and especially those people doing talab al-ilm and doing dawah, and in everything that you're doing, try to just do your best to purify your intention. And the shaitan's going to come in the middle of the action. You're going to start showing off, and you're going to have to just, it's internal. The niyyah, mahala niyyah aqalb, the place of your intention, it's not on your hands, and it's not then whispering and saying, now I'm going to purify my niyyah. I'm going to purify my niyyah, and I'm going to do 4 rakats of salat. No, the mahala niyyah is in the qalb. It's in the heart. So just say to yourself internally, your heart, purify your intention. Hoping that your action will be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, directing it solely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do your best to forget what the people say. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Anything I said was correct, bismillah azza wa jal. Anything I said that was incorrect for myself and shaitan, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.